of paint buildup on all of our trim in the upstairs of our home. So I'm going to show you what I'm doing to remove it and then show you the steps along the way so you can see exactly what it should look like as the process goes on. So what I'm using today though is a product by Dumond, and it is called Smart Strip. It's a paint thinner remover, and it has no VOC. It's safe and effective, and it's earth friendly. It's water-based, so you can use your paintbrush and then wash it in your sink. So you don't have to go outside and worry about all the oil based or anything like that, so it's really great. In addition to the stripper, I'm using a laminated paper, also by Dumond. It is sold just with the stripper, if you would like to use this. What this does is you apply this over your area where you've applied the stripper, and it helps keep it wet because you can leave the stripper on your wood for up to 24 hours. And what that does is it really just helps eat out all that paint. It does say that you can remove up to 8 levels of paint in one shot. So I have a lot of paint. So in some of the other areas of my home where I've tried this out in this room, I'm going on round 2 just because, like I said, it's 133 years old, and so there's a lot of paint in here. So some of the things you're gonna need. Now, this is no VOC. However, I did test for lead. There's another video that I did to teach you how to test for lead at home by yourself. And because I do have that, I am taking precautionary measures. So one, starting off with a lovely outfit. I just picked this up at Walmart because I don't mind if it gets ruined. I have goggles with the strap. And these ones do go around the sides of my face just to help provide extra protection, especially once you start getting to the dusty type areas of when you're removing the paint. It's really good for that. Next up, I have a respirator mask. This I just purchased at Home Depot. This one is approved for lead paint. So it comes with filters, and these filters just snap on and off. You can buy more of them. Buy refill packs and then keep your respirator and just keep using this. It goes around your head, and then it also has a clasp that goes around the lower of your neck. That works really well to help keep safe. In addition, I'm wearing rubber gloves that are not just any old ordinary rubber gloves. These are to help protect against liquids, especially chemical liquids. So I just bought these at Walmart though in the hardware section, and they're just silicone. For the paint, mine's already in here. I just have a brush, a very jumpy dollar store brush. Because if you don't really need a nice one, you're just pushing this on to your woodwork and then covering it up. So, and I also have 2 different size paint scrapers. I prefer the flexible, so these ones bend actually, versus the ones that are stiff, but they will not bend. Because once you're going back over the wood, you really want that give a little bit so you can go around edges and whatnot. I've got 2 different sizes. To cut my paper, when I put my laminated paper on top of it, and then you can use scissors, but I do find that it's easier with like a pocket knife or a box cutter. You just want to cut off your edges just to not waste your paper. Because it is kind of pricey. Next up, I have a 3M sanding sponge. This is medium grit, so I can go back over and just nicely rub off any extra paint that I have. So I do also have a heat gun that I have been using in certain areas. to put my roll on the floor and reach up. All you do, you apply the stripper that your paper on, and then you just let it work its magic. What I've done is I've let it sit for 24 hours, and then I come back through and peel my paper off. So let's show you guys what that looks like. So, at the top of this doorway, I still have the paper. So what I'm going to do is just peel it off. Now, of course, I should be using my gloves right now. Putting my mask up, but I'm just going to show you guys what that looks like so you can see all that paint coming off. So it's really easy. All you'll do then is then use a scraper to come back through and to scrape. What I've done is I just take this and I simply scrape off the excess, just like that. Then I do have a heat gun, like I mentioned. Really helpful in just removing it even further past the layers of paint that I was able to get off of the stripper. This is a Wagner heat gun. This one is the Furno 500. It's a heat gun. So you can change the temperature and you can change the fan speed. So I do like that. There's also different tips that you can use to point an A where you need to. You use heat and move. I'll have to do another video on that, but this really was about the stripper because it's so easy to do. And like I said, I've got a lot of paint in the upstairs of my home to remove. So let's move over to another window so I can show you what it looks like once that paper is off and you can see through that paint. So quickly, I'm gonna show you up there again. You can see that paint coming off. And then over here, this is the paint I've removed, or I've removed the paper from here. You can see that it's real, like, crispy-like. So this is where the heat gun has come in help to remove this. So you would just scrape and take it off. So it does usually come off really easily. Right now, this stripper is very dry. This was from a couple days ago. So what you can do is reapply another coat on here, let it sit for another 24 hours, and it should come off really easily. So, I do want to mention that it is negative 25. 5 degrees outside here, so I really don't have many windows open. I do have one little window in the back open. But the great thing with this stripper is that it's a no VOC, so you don't really have to worry about that. And the reason I had my mask on was because I knew I felt like people just wanted to get too careful. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments. If not, be happy to say by this time of day. I just actually found them in a video done by This Old House. So I thought, hey, that looks like a really great way to strip paint. And because I have many, many layers and years of paint to be removed, I figured this was a safe and effective way to try it. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you on the next video. And make sure you check out the other videos I've done to tell you how to test for lead, as well as many other videos like refinishing floors and staining floors and stuff like that. Have a great day, guys.